So have you guys heard about Maison Crivelli yet? I've been speaking about them for a good year plus on the channel, with my favorite fragrance from this house being Iris Malakan. Today I'm reviewing this particular fragrance, a favorite of mine, one of my favorite releases of last year. It's absolutely delicious. It's a gourmand iris leather fragrance with green notes running throughout it. And I'm going to let you know a little bit about the brand as well. So if you want to find out about Iris Malakan, then please stay tuned. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Sebastian. And yes, today I'm talking about Iris Malakan from Maison Crivelli. So I first discovered this house probably in 2019. And I got to do my first video on the channel with several fragrances, including Iris Malakan, probably like in the height of the pandemic last year. And as soon as I smelled this one, I was blown away by how great it is. It is a fantastic smelling fragrance, really, really to die for. Excellent smell, one I love. I love gourmand fragrances, and I also love iris fragrances, and I just featured this in a alternative to Dior en Parfum fragrances video. If you didn't catch that, go catch it. It doesn't smell anything like Dior en Parfum, but I think it's a great alternative because it uses the iris with the leather, but it's also going in a different direction. Anyway, I'll tell you more about Iris Malakan and a little bit about Maison Crivelli, but before I do, if this is your first time tuning into the channel and you still haven't subscribed, please do click the subscribe button below and also click the bell so that you'll be notified for future videos and giveaways. So how many of you know Iris Malakan? How many of you watched my video, review of the fragrances from this house? Plus I've featured Iris Malakan in many other videos, because it is really a great, great fragrance. It's created by a perfumer by the name of Mark Zini, who I'm not too familiar with, but he's created something absolutely delicious here that I can't get enough of. And as I mentioned in my video from a few days ago of Dior en Parfum alternatives, I said Dior en Parfum, or the whole Dior en line, is what got me really into enjoying iris. And this is actually taking iris to a whole new level. Really a delicious level. So Maison Crivelli's Iris Malakan is a 2020 launch. As I said, the perfumer is Mark Zini. It's considered a powdery gourmand leather. Price and size, 100 ml for $260. It's Eau de Parfum concentration. And then I do also want to say Maison Crivelli is getting the rollout now in the USA. They do have a distributor now, and you'll be able to find a lot of their fragrances at various retailers across the country. But you can also get the fragrance from Twisted Lily, and I have a link to Twisted Lily in the info box, and you can use my discount code. It's PerfumeGuy10, which will save you 10% off of any purchase there, including the Maison Crivelli fragrances. So for notes in Iris Malakan, you've got cypress essential oil, lentisk essential oil, and lentisk is mastic resin, galbanum absolute, orris butter, mimosa absolute, vanilla, leather accord, amber, and musks. So I'm going to circle back to Dior en Parfum again. Dior en Parfum is known for the iris or orris and leather, and this is pretty much that, because the fragrance wears very powdery but also buttery. And it's interesting, I think since orris to me goes buttery, it acts more like a suede leather for me rather than, you know, your traditional leather. There's a very buttery texture when you're wearing this, but still very powdery at the same time. So because this whole Dior en Parfum has this buttery, smooth, leathery, powdery iris experience, I think that's the reason why I like this one. But hold on, it's not only the reason why I like this one, because when you're enjoying the leather with the iris plus that vanilla kind of going to the gourmand direction, then you're all of a sudden struck with galbanum. What the heck is galbanum? This is an amazing green note that I'm absolutely obsessed with, which for me, yes, it can be enjoyed on its own, individually, smelling of nothing but galbanum, but it is such a great contrast thrown into fragrances to kind of cut through everything you're enjoying, to give you this kind of like a wake-up thing with this unique smell that kind of like swims through the notes and kind of like I said, wakes you up. And that's kind of what I like about this one, that whole contrast with the three traditional notes you're so used to, then you're, you know, struck with that galbanum note, the bitter green kind of resinous sticky kind of touch that kind of runs through the composition. For me, this fragrance is mostly about those four notes, but there's some other things happening. It definitely gets musky here. We have definite musky qualities, and of course it gets ambery, and this is kind of like, you know, helping that vanilla along to create a kind of a more gourmand style. When I say gourmand, and this is what the brand actually credits this fragrance as being, a powdery gourmand leather. Yes, it has gourmand touches, but it's not necessarily your full-on, in-your-face, sweet, tooth-rottingly gourmand kind of a fragrance. It's not that. But it borders the gourmand style, and I like it. I like that about this one. I like it because the gourmand is subtle. You kind of like enjoy it. Like, it's almost like a diet gourmand fragrance, kind of like you're not fully like taking on all the sweet stuff. You know, you've got all that buttery iris in here, that kind of like smooth buttery leather as well. And then of course that galbanum. But you know, you do experience the amber, as I said. Mimosa does come in a little bit. It adds a little bit of a more of a powdery touch, kind of accentuates the powderiness of the orris butter. Lightly nutty kind of almondy touch there. And then you've got a little bit of that cypress, very, very faint, not much cypress comes in, which kind of contributes to a little bit of a greener touch to the fragrance already experiencing from that galbanum note. As you might have noticed, I didn't read any citrus notes in this particular fragrance, and it definitely doesn't need it because the fragrance itself is amazing as it is. The way it's created, it's fantastic. And as I said, it was one of my favorite fragrances of last year. In fact, I featured it in a video of my favorite fragrances of 2020. It's that fantastic. It's really, really great, and I believe, for me, I enjoy this particular fragrance so much from this house because I just love the way it smells. One thing I do have to say, it does hint at a little bit of a few other fragrances that I have, especially something like Comme des Garçons Copper, but when you compare them side by side, they're completely different. And I think what's going on is Comme des Garçons Copper is amber with galbanum, but there's a lot more amber in there and a lot more galbanum, whereas this is more leather, iris, and then of course vanilla and galbanum. So they're different, but lightly they hint at one another, and then when you connect them or you smell them side by side, you'll definitely notice that they're not identical whatsoever. This is a special fragrance, a very, very special fragrance. I absolutely love wearing it. There's also lots of sexy touches in here. I find the iris with the leather very, very sexy, as I did with Dior Homme Parfum, and I do with this particular fragrance as well. I hope you guys get to try Maison Crivelli's Iris Malakan. It is now selling. I have a link to Twisted Lily in the info box. And of course, the entire brand is now sold at Twisted Lily, and I have that link in the info box. But please let me know if you've sampled Iris Malakan, and what do you think about it? Does the idea of this particular fragrance sound great if you haven't sampled it? Do you enjoy iris? Do you enjoy leather? And what about galbanum? Have you experienced fragrances with galbanum? Let me know. Put a comment down. But you've got to get your nose on this, especially if you like fragrances like Dior Homme Parfum or any iris, buttery iris, leather kind of combo. Again, these are not the same fragrances, kind of similar notes, but going in complete different directions. I hope you guys get to try this Iris Malakan, and that's what I have for you today. But let me know if you're a fan of this fragrance. Let me know if you've discovered the fragrances of Maison Crivelli, or if you're curious to try them. I'd like to find out. Either way, guys, thanks so much for watching today's video. If you have any questions or comments, please do list below. Please like this video. Please share it. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and I'll be back with more videos very soon. Have a good one. Goodbye.